For the last couple of days, I have been experimenting with new PCB motor ideas, and today I'm going to talk about one of them. As you know, my PCB motor is slotless, and there's a couple of advantages for using this configuration, but I wanted to know if I could make the motor stronger by using a core or a backplate, very similar to what I did in my PCB electromagnet project. In that video, I found that the backplating option produced more efficient results. The middle core will also increase the area of our PCB motor, so for this experiment, we're just going to focus on backplating. Now, I have already tested something similar 3 years ago with this ferrite sheet sticker, which did some minor improvements to the torque, but I ignored one simple fact: cogging. The best way to explain this is by looking at this 1 Hz coil test. The attraction between the ferrite and the magnets is so strong that the coil's magnetic field becomes negligible, which basically creates cogging and doesn't allow our old motor to rotate. Now, this is where I was 3 years ago, but now I have this new motor that can operate at lower temperatures and has more torque. So maybe adding a core to this new motor can overcome cogging and improve the coil's magnetic field. No cogging was observed with this ferrite sheet sticker, but trying a thicker piece of steel did make it stop. This is not the prettiest thing, but it did improve the coil's magnetic field by 1 mTa, and the motor was also spinning. Now, if we go back to the PCB electromagnet data, we know that this ferrite sheet stickers did not have the highest permeability. Iron and steel had better results, so the next thing I had to figure out is how to integrate these materials with our PCB motor, obviously in the simplest way possible. My first idea was to use a flexible PCB with steel stiffeners. To make sure that the motor doesn't cog with the steel, I selected the thinnest option. And I also made 4 different designs. One without steel for comparison, one with 6 tiny triangles, another one with bigger plates to cover the 6 coils, and the last sample covering the whole stator area. Now, these 3 designs could still bend, so to make sure we avoid the issue we observed in the stepper PCB motor, I also made this alternative that has an FR4 stiffener on the backside. The stiffener seems to be hand assembled, as I noticed that some of them were slightly misaligned, but this shouldn't affect us that much. These samples had an average resistance of 27.8 ohms. This is a little bit larger than the FR4 reading, which is a little bit strange as they both have the same coil design and same copper thickness. This means that the flex control sample has a lower magnetic field strength because of this higher resistance. I measured the field of every motor using this 3D printed holder to make sure I get the same exact spot every time. And as 5 volts, these are the peak results I got, which basically confirmed that none of the motors made any improvements with the steel stiffener backing.
And that's pure engineering disappointment. On the good side, all the motors managed to rotate and reach the same maximum speed as the FR4 sample. I also measured the KV ratings of the motors, and there wasn't a huge variation. But as expected, the torque had 0 improvements. Now, at this point, I was just giving up on this project. The stiffeners were clearly magnetic, but my PCB manufacturer couldn't provide their datasheet. So the material either didn't have high permeability or wasn't thick enough. I wanted to dig more into this thickness question. So the first thing I tried is stacking 2 steel stiffeners back to back to double the thickness. But nothing actually improved. As a final verdict, I decided to test this other PCB, which had the same steel stiffener but 0.5 mm thick, and the improvement was less than 1 mTa. Now, I also tested this iron plate, which is going to be a part from my next rotor build. This is 0.6 mm thick, and using it as a backplate, the magnetic field improved by 1.6 mTa, which is the best result I managed to get, but cogging happened. In this test, I was using the iron rotor, but when I switched to the aluminium one, it kind of worked. So for now, I'm just going to shelf this idea and eventually test it with my future rotors. But until then, this is mid busted. An extra 1.6 mTa doesn't make a huge improvement to the torque.